Good morning, students. This is Karthik, Department of Chemistry from Mount Zion Matriculation High Secondary School. So today we are going to learn the new lesson, S block elements. So why we study S block elements? The simple reason, see, what is this? This is the soap and detergent. So simply the sodium soap. So the element from the S block element. The second one, what is this? This is cake. So the sodium bicarbonate, which is used for making cake tastefully. So the sodium from the S block element. S block element, which is used for making some of the medicine. What is this? This is the plaster Paris. The calcium element, which is used for making plaster Paris. Yes, the cement. So the calcium, the element calcium, which is used for making cement. What is the next one? Yes, battery. The lithium, which is used for making batteries. And then fireworks, strontium and barium, which is used for making fireworks. So the S block element, which is used for making many materials. Example, detergent, cake, medicine, firework, cement, plaster Paris, and then batteries. So that's why we are going to study S block element. What are S block elements? So simply, the S block elements of the periodic table are those in which the last electron enter in the outermost S orbital. Last electron enter to the S of cells. That's why the elements are called S block elements. For example, lithium, what is the atomic number? Atomic number 3. So 1s2, 2s1. Okay, the last electron entered to the 2s of cell. And then sodium, what is the atomic number? 11. So the last electron entered to the S orbital. So 1s2, 2s2, 2p6. And then 3s1. Okay. So the next one is beryllium. What is the atomic number? 4. So 1s2, 2s2. So why we call the S block element? It's simply the lost electron enter to the S subshell. That's why this block element is called a S block element. And then the S block elements are present in the periodic table left corner. So there is a 2 S block element. One is the alkali metal, another one is the alkaline earth metal. So this is the new lesson, lesson number 5. The lesson name, alkali and alkaline earth metal. So the next one is the learning objectivity. What is learning objectivity? So what are the content present in the lesson? The first one, they explain the properties of alkali metals and alkaline earth metal. The second one, recognize the anomalous properties of lithium and beryllium. The next one, list the uses of alkali metals and alkaline earth metal. Describe the general characteristics of alkali metals and alkaline earth metal. Appreciate the biological importance of sodium and potassium, magnesium and calcium. Explain the preparation, properties and uses of calcium oxide, calcium hydroxide, gypsum and plaster Paris. So the S block element. So the elements belong to the group 1 and group 2. In the modern periodic table are called as S block elements. The elements belong to the two groups are commonly known as alkali and alkaline earth metal. The first group is called alkali metal. The second group is called alkaline earth metal. In this unit, we are going to study the properties, uses, important compounds and biological importance. The first one, alkali metal. So what is alkali? The word alkali is derived from alkali. What is the meaning of alkali? That is the plant ash. Okay, they are referring to the original source of alkaline substance. Generally, alkali means plant ash. Okay, one more question. So, what is the meaning of alkali? That is plant ash. So, plant ash, we burn it completely, burn it, it produces the ash. So, that ash contains alkali metal. Generally, the potash present in the plant ash. Okay, the next one, the water extract of burnt plant ash is called potash. So, it contains mainly potassium carbonate. So, on the plant ash, la maximum in the present diagram, potassium carbonate. Okay, so the alkali metal group consists of the element. Okay, that is the next two mark question. What are the elements present in the first group are alkali metal. So the lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium and francium. Okay, these are the elements present in the alkali metal. Okay, they are all metal generally soft. So alkali metals are soft and also highly reactive. So most reactive metals present in the first group and the second group, and then they form oxides and hydroxides, for example sodium oxide. And then what is the hydroxide? Sodium hydroxide. Okay, and these compounds are basic in nature. Okay, so oxides of alkali metal, hydroxides of alkali metals are in the basic natures. General characteristics of alkali metal. Alkali metals are highly reactive and found in the nature only as a compound, not a free state. Compounds mean it combined with the sulfide ore, oxide ore, carbonate ore. Okay, it is not in the free state. Okay, so generally alkali metals found in the nature only as a compound, not a free state. Okay, the rubidium and cesium are found associated in the minute quantities. Okay, so cesium and rubidium, so present in the nature very minute quantity with the minerals of other alkali metals. Francium is a radioactivity element. So what is a radioactivity element? So generally the change in the nuclear reaction or the change in the nuclear composition is called a radioactivity element. So what is the difference between radioactivity element and a normal element? Generally the normal element, that is a normal chemical reaction, takes place with the change of the electron from one compound to another compound. But the radioactivity elements mean change in the nuclear composition is called a radioactivity. So generally or chemical reactions appadina electron undu or compound la inda or compound ku transfer aagum, but radioactivity elements na completely one nucleus vandu another nucleus ah convert aagum. Okay, that is a radioactivity element and does not occur appreciably in nature. So very minute quantity present in the nature. Francium is a highly radioactivity. Its longest lived isotopes, francium isotopes, has a half life only 21 minutes. That is T half equal to 21 minutes. So maximum stability 21 minutes. After that the isotope changes to another element. Okay, so what is T half? That is half life, the time taken for the element to be reduced half of the amount. So T half is the one more question. So what is the T half of the francium element? 21 minutes. The next one, abundance of important alkali metal and their sources. The first one, the element lithium, abundance in the earth crust, so 0.0018%. And then relative abundance. What is relative abundance? the dividing the number of species from one group divided by the total number of species from the all the group. So that is the relative abundance. Okay, 35. The source of the lithium is spodumene. So lithium, aluminium silicate. Okay, spodumene is the mineral source of the lithium. The next one is the sodium. So what is the how much amount present in the earth crust? 2.27% and then relative abundance 7. So what is the main source? Rock salt, sodium chloride. And then potassium present in the earth crust 1.84% and then relative abundance 8. And then the main source of the potassium is sylvite, KCl. Rubidium and cesium, the next one. So rubidium and cesium, very minute quantity present in the earth crust. So how much amount present in the earth crust? 0.0078%. And then 23 is the relative abundance. And then no convenient source. So obtained by the byproduct of the lithium process. So these two elements are from the byproduct of the lithium. Okay, so that's why this is very minute quantity present in the earth crust. Next one, cesium, how much amount present in the earth crust? 0.00026% and then relative abundance 46. And then francium is the radioactivity elements, so very minute quantity present in the earth crust. The francium also the byproduct of the lithium process. Next one, electronic configuration. The general valence shell electronic configuration of alkali metal is NS1. So what is N? N is the periodic number. What is S? S is the subshell. So how much electron present in the outermost shell? Only one electron. So the general configuration is NS1. That is a one mark question. There is a general valency shell electronic configuration of alkali metal is NS1. So only one electron present in the outermost shell. Yes, say that lithium, helium with 2s1, and then sodium 3s1, potassium 4s1, rubidium 5s1, and then cesium 6s1, and then francium 7s1. So only one electron present in the outermost shell. And then common oxidation state. So all these elements are highly electropositive nature. That is one more question. So generally metals are of electropositive nature. And then S block elements are highly electropositive nature. So they readily lost the valency electron to give the monovalent cation. For example, lithium. And then accept energy. It gives lithium plus with the loss of one electron. So simply the alkali metals readily lost the valency electron. So it's form a monovalent cation. So what is the oxidation number of the alkali metal? Plus 1. Okay. So this is the one mark question. So alkali metal have only one oxidation state, which is plus 1. One mark question. The next one. Atomic and ionic radii. So what is atomic radii? The distance between the center of its nucleus and the outermost shell containing the valence electron. Ionic radii means if we consider ions, so that is a ionic radii. If it is consider atoms, atomic radii. If it is consider ions, it's a ionic radii. So being the first element of each period, the alkali metal having the largest atomic and ionic radii in their respective periods. Periods means from the left to right. So left to right means the first element from the alkali metal. So it is the largest one. And then it will move to left to right. The size will be decreases because the extra electron enter to the same subshell but increase the nuclear charge. So the nucleus attract effectively the valence electron. So the size will be decreases. On moving down the group, there is an increasing in the numbers of shells and therefore atomic and ionic radii increases. Generally, atomic ready is decreases from left to right because of the reason increase in nuclear charge, and then atomic or ionic ready increases from top to bottom. This is period, this is group. So from the group, atomic or ionic ready increases from top to bottom because of the reason the extra electron enter to the different shells. Okay, and then decrease in nuclear charge. Okay, so on moving down the group, there is an increasing in the number of shells. So therefore, atomic and ionic ready increases. The monovalent ion are smaller than the respective parent atoms as expected. For example, we are going to compare the lithium and Li plus. Okay, what is the atomic number of lithium? 3. So configuration 1s2, 2s1. And then next one, lithium plus, loss of an electron from the lithium atom, so it's become a lithium ion. So same atomic number, but only the difference number of electrons. So 1s2 because loss of an electron from the outermost shell. Okay, see, this is K shell and then this is L shell. So the two electron accommodate in the K shell and then one more electron in the L shell. Okay, that is the two shell in the lithium atom, but ion. So there is only two electron. So the K shell, so the two electron can be accommodate in the K shell. Okay, the one shell is reduced because of the reason the loss of one electron from the lithium. So we conclude lithium is larger than lithium plus. So the monovalent ions are smaller than the respective parent atoms as expected. So in the ions on the size on the parent oda compare pannum bodhu smaller a irukum. The next one, physical properties. First one, atomic ready or metallic radius. Lithium 1.52, sodium 1.82, potassium 2.27, rubidium 2.48 and cesium 2.65. Ionic ready in angstrom 0.76, 1.08, 1.38, 1.52, 1.67. This is from the top to bottom. Generally, atomic or ionic ready increases from top to bottom. The melting point, lithium 181. So the melting point in degree Celsius, lithium 181, sodium 98, potassium 63, rubidium 39, cesium 28.5. So generally, in the first group, melting point decreases from top to bottom. And then boiling point in degree Celsius, lithium 1347, sodium 881, potassium 766, rubidium 688, and then cesium 705. The first ionization enthalpy in kilojoule mole inverse 520.2 in lithium, 495.8 sodium, 418.8 potassium, 403.0 rubidium, 375.7 cesium. The next one, electronegativity, the Pauling scale, the data from the Pauling scale. So what is electronegativity? Already know that it attract the shared pair of electron towards itself. Okay, so what is the lithium 1.0, sodium 0.9, potassium 0.8, rubidium 0.8 and the cesium 0.7. So the electronegativity decreases from top to bottom, and then density in gram centimeter power minus 3, 0.54 in lithium, sodium 0.97, potassium 0.86, rubidium 1.53 and cesium 1.90. And then standard potential energy. So what is standard potential energy? So that means the tendency for a chemical species to be reduced and is measured in volt at a standard condition. So for lithium, -3.04 volt, sodium -2.71 volt, potassium -2.92 volt, rubidium -2.93 volt, cesium -2.93 volt. So the next one is hydration enthalpy in kilojoule mole inverse. What is hydration enthalpy? The hydration energy is the amount of energy released when one mole of ions undergo hydration. For lithium, -506, for sodium -406, potassium -330, for rubidium -310, and then cesium -273. So the hydration enthalpy decreases from top to bottom. The hydration enthalpy is inversely proportional to size. Size increases, hydration enthalpy decreases. Next one, ionization enthalpy. So what is ionization enthalpy? So the minimum amount of energy required to remove the most loosely bonded electron from the valence shell of isolated neutral gaseous atom in its grounded state. That is called a ionization enthalpy. The first one, alkali metal have a lowest ionization enthalpy compared to other element present in the respective period. Period means left to right. Why ionization enthalpy lowest in the alkali metal? Because of the reasons. So the minimum amount of energy is required to remove the loosely bonded electron from the valence system. But the left to right size decreases, nuclear charge increases, that is extra electron enter to the same subshell. So the maximum amount of energy required to remove the electron from the valence shell. The next one, as we go down the group, that means top to bottom, the ionization enthalpy decreases due to the increase in the size. So simply, size increases, the extra electron enter to the new subshells. So the nuclear charge decreases. So the minimum amount of energy is required to remove the electrons. The next one, in addition, the number of inner shells also increases, which in the turn increase the magnitude of screening effect. That means increase the screening effect value, and consequently the ionization enthalpy decreases down the group. The next one, the second ionization enthalpy of alkali metals are very high because of the reason. For example, lithium. What is atomic number 3? So, accept some amount of energy, then it form a lithium plus and then loss of an electron. So now it is, there is a 2 electron in the lithium ions. So this is like a noble gas configuration. We spend more energy to remove the electrons from the outermost shell. Yes, the removal of an electron from the alkali metal gives monovalent cation, having the stable configurations similar to the noble gas. So therefore, it becomes very difficult to remove the second electron from the stable configurations already attained. The next one, hydration enthalpy. What is hydration enthalpy? The hydration enthalpy or hydration energy is the amount of energy released when one mole of ions undergo hydration. So lithium salt are more soluble than the salt of other metal of group 1 element. Okay, example, so lithium perchlorate is up to 12 times more soluble than sodium perchlorate, potassium perchlorate, rubidium perchlorate and cesium perchlorate. So in the salt oda compare pannumbodhu lithium perchlorate vandu 12 times more soluble. Cesium perchlorate has a solubility only 10 power minus 3 times of that lithium perchlorate. This high solubility of lithium salt is due to strong solvation of small size of lithium ions. So simple reason, size. Hydration enthalpy or hydration energy is inversely proportional to size. That means increase the hydration enthalpy, decrease the size. When size increases, hydration enthalpy decreases. So lithium oda energy evlo energy release aagudha appadina minus 519, but cesium pathina minus 264. So idhula endha half amount da energy release aagudhu. So size increases, then hydration enthalpy decreases. The next one, electronegativity. Already know that the attract shared pair of electron towards itself. So that is the electronegativity. So alkali metal have a comparatively smaller value of electronegativity than the other elements in the respective periods. Electronegativity increases from left to right because of the simple reason, one, size, another one is the nuclear charge. So size decreases and then electronegativity increases, and then nuclear charge also increases, and then electronegativity decreases from top to bottom because of the reason, same reason, size and nuclear charge. Size increases, nuclear charge decreases. So when they react with other element, they usually produce ionic compound. For example, the sodium react with the halogen. Okay, it gives sodium chloride. So this is the metal halides. For example, they react with the halogen to form a ionic halide. So the alkali metal react with the other elements, they usually produced ionic compound. That is one more question. The next one, flame color and the spectra. So what is spectra? As the characteristics wavelength of electromagnetic radiation that is emitted or absorbed by an object or the substance, atom or molecule. So that is called a spectra. So flame colors, when the alkali metal salt moistened with the concentrated hydrochloric acid, that means we are going to make a paste alkali metal with hydrochloric acid, or heated on the platinum wire in a flame, they show characteristics colored flames as shown in the below table. So wavelength in the nanometer, the lithium is the cremerson red. Cremerson red means it is a pink color. Okay, and then what is the wavelength? 670.8. then sodium, yellow color, that is the golden color. What is the wavelength? 589.2. and then potassium, lilac, that means violet color. So what is the wavelength? 766.5 nanometer. And then rubidium, reddish violet. So what is the wavelength? 780.0. and then cesium, blue color. So 455.5 nanometer. So the heat in the flame exited the valency electron to a higher energy level. So when it drop back to its actual energy level, the excess energy is emitted as a light whose wavelength is in the visible region as shown in the above table. Yes. So how to form a color? Simply heated in the flame. So nama paste flame la heat pannumbodhu valence electrons vandu exited to the higher energy. So higher energy ponuchu appadina, and then after sometimes loss some energy and then come back to the original level. So the excess of energy is emitted as a visible light. Yes, the lithium is a red color flame. sodium is the strong. So what is the color? That is a yellow color. It may orange. Potassium, lilac, that is a violet. And then rubidium, it's a red violet. And then cesium. So cesium is the blue color or a violet color. So what are the possible questions in this session? How color is produced when an alkali metal introduced in the flame? Answer of the question from the book page 128. So from the answer, the alkali metal salt moistened with concentrated hydrochloric acid. That means we are going to make a paste. Then we are going to introduce into flame with the platinum wire. It produced color. Because of the reason, the heat in the flame exited the valence electron to the higher energy level. So when it draw back to the its original energy level, the excess amount of energy is emitted as a light whose wavelength is in the visible region. So up to the visible region. So the question, the answer from the alkali metal to up to visible region. Okay, no need to write the table. The next one, recapitulation, that means what we studied in this session. First one, general characteristics of alkali metal. Second one, the electronic configuration, common oxidation state, atomic and ionic ionization enthalpy of alkali metal, hydration enthalpy and electronegativity of alkali metal, flame color and the spectra of alkali metal. Thank you, students.